magical portal. Very interesting. We thought it was just a knot hole in a tree. We're kind of looking for an owl. Why? I'm not going to tell you. We're looking for an owl. It turns out it was a portal. And we landed there. They're having a big magical fairy tea party.
Yay!
Like the fairy do. And the king was there. And he told us this wonderful story about how their realm had recently been saved from a dragon by a miraculous knight. Which was like the story.
Yes.
The fairies and their knight and their king and their dragon. Of old in a kingdom bold, there lived a fearsome dragon, and the king he was in great distress, and the country's spirits flagged. Until one day there came a knight who was handsome, bold, and charming, and he slew the dragon with his sword, with a smile that was so disarming, with a hey and a ho and a hey not no, and a smile that was so disarming. Said the king, I wish to know your name, but the knight said, do not bother, for the name of the knight that runs and he is the same as any other. So the king tonight, my daughter's bed, you shall take your leisure, and she'll reward you for your deeds the night of exhausting pleasure. With a hey and a ho and a hey and a yo, the night of exhausting pleasure. One daughter, she had raven hair, a maiden young and chaste, and she slept all night in the pale moonlight, naked to the waist. The other daughter, she was fair, the fairest in the town, and she slept all night in the pale moonlight, naked from her small waist down. With a hey and a ho and a hey and a yo, naked from her small waist down. Well, the night he spent many an hour behind the castle walls. But the ending to our story isn't what it seems at all. For in neither bed of neither maid was he repaid for his glory. But he slept all night with the king instead, for this is a fair.